Amen? Hallelujah. Are we all happy today? Amen? God is good. And all the time, God is good. That means that we ought to be happy not just today, but in every time and all the time. You know, as I was listening, thank you very much for all the brothers and sisters who stood here in front today, from the youngest to the eldest. May the Lord continue to increase your countenance. May the Lord continue to increase those giftings that He has given you for His purposes in glory. Amen? As I was listening to the song of Glyza, I realize and I recognize one thing. You know, people who are here or even online or wherever you are, whatever your background is, whatever your race, whatever your culture, sabi ni Kuya Will, lalaki ka man o babae ka, young or old. My dear brothers and sisters, we have a common denominator. We are all in need. You might be the grandson of who's the richest man today? Bill Gates, na walang grandson si Bill Gates. Sabi natin, Bill Gates, I thought about Elon Musk. You might be the grandson or you might be a distant relation for Bill Gates or you might be Bill Gates. You are in need. You are in need, my dear brothers and sisters. You and me are in need. And though many or some probably are not in need of money, some probably are not in need of health, some are probably not in need of education, but each and every one of us are in need. And we all need the Lord. Amen. We all need the Lord. I need the Lord. You need the Lord. We all need the Lord. Amen, church? People need the Lord. And if you were listening to the encouragement, exhortation of Cherry earlier, it talks about love. It talks about love. Because the very purpose, the reason that we are here, because of God, and God is love. Sabi niya dun. Amen, church? God is love. Amen. So it is my prayer, my dear brothers and sisters, that after today's service, we do not just know and realize that God is love. I know we already know that. That is already an information that we know, that we have heard many, many times. But my dear brothers and sisters, it is my prayer that after today's service, that we truly experience that love. That we truly encounter that love. Sometimes, we talk a lot of times about love. Sometimes, if there is a topic that each and every one of us is very good, we can all be advisor, is about love. But sometimes, we do not truly experience it. Because in order to experience one, you need to be able to be in a capacity not only to receive, but to give. That is the full meaning of experience. Amen, church? So it is my prayer that we do not just know about love, that we do not just learn about love, that we do not just receive the love of our brothers and sisters. But I pray to God that we will be in a stand, in a position to be able to show and share that love as well. Amen, church? And we know that the nature of love that we are talking about, that is the nature of love that Jesus says, greater love has no one than this, that He gave His life for His friend. Amen, church? Although the Bible did not say that you give your life for brother or for sister, but who is our friend? You are my friend if you do my command, thus saith Jesus. Amen? Greater love has no one than this, that we can give our life to Jesus. Amen, church? Amen? Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Sabi sa kanta, maghari ka, maghari ka. Maghari ka, Panginoon, pagharian mo ang buhay namin ngayong araw na to. Pagharian mo ang iyong iglesia, pagharian mo ang bawat pamilya. Rain upon the heart, upon the life, upon the situation, in circumstances of each and everyone. That is our prayer, that is our desire to happen today, mga kapatid. Amen? Pero sabi din niya, kailangan meron tayong gawin. Kailangan meron tayong gawin. And if I'm going to give the message in one word, decision. Decision. Today is the day, my dear brothers and sisters, and I pray that after this service, that we are in a position to make that decision. Amen. Na after this service or during this service, that we can make that decision. That we can make the decision. My dear brothers and sisters, we have made our decision long time ago. A lot of people, they write their will. They already make their decision. What will happen when they die? But the most important decision that we need to make, my dear brothers and sisters, it is my prayer that we will do that today. Amen? And I pray that our Lord Holy Spirit will not only give us that spirit of understanding, that will not only open our heart and mind, but the Lord Holy Spirit will give us that patience. Patience to listen and to receive. This is very important, church. This is very important. If there was a message that I want you to understand and receive fully from the beginning until the end, let this be that message. Let this be that message. Most gracious Lord and Heavenly Father, thank you very much that you have gathered us all here today. Thank you, Father God, that you have allowed us this wonderful opportunity to remember and commemorate even our Independence Day, because 124 years ago, you have allowed our forefathers to make that decision to be independent, Father God. And Lord, we pray that the same Spirit who enlightened them, the same Spirit who have made them bold, that same Spirit who guided them to make that decision to be independent. Let that same Spirit, Father God, enlighten us and help us make that decision today. Lord, breathe your life upon your word. At Father God, may each and every word and passage, Father God, will work in opening our mind, will work in opening our heart, our spirit being, in order for us to fully receive from you. Lord, we rebuke whatever works and wiles in the schemes of the enemy, Father God. We rebuke whatever spiritualities that are not of you, Father, to be out of this place right now. In Jesus' name, guard every mind, guard every heart, guard every life, Lord, that every life and every heart and every mind will be put, Father God, in submission to you today. Lord, cover your servant with your most precious blood. Hide me behind you, Lord, so that my dear brothers and sisters won't just be concentrating or merely staring at me, but to you, O God, who have sent me to stand in here to share these words from you. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Can I ask each and everyone, declaration of faith, ask your neighbors, or ask brothers and sisters next to you, are you ready to be freed? Are you ready to be freed? Are you ready to make that decision? You know, although it is very easy to ping that ping pong ball to your neighbor, but what I want us to do is say that, Lord, I am ready. Amen. Lord, I am ready. Lord, enlighten me to make that decision. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And again, my dear brothers and sisters, in line with our lovely Philippines 124th Independence Day. Our message today is about independence. Amen? So, I'll just want to give a little bit of history sa na-research ko. Children, young people, youth, listen to this because it is very important part of who you are. Okay? Listen to this because this is a very important part of who you are. Adults who na medyo nakalimutan natin yung ating history, recap lang po. Amen? So we know, my dear brothers and sisters, that the Philippines was subjected under colonial rule. Amen? We were colonized by the Spanish for nearly, it's actually 377 years to be exact. Amen? When the Spaniards, under the guise of a Portuguese explorer, his name is Fernando de Magallanes. Amen? He arrived in the Philippines in March 1521 in Limasawa. In Limasawa Island. So just for us to connect with history. Amen? So the Spaniards arrived in the Philippines in 1521, my dear brothers and sisters, and for 377 years, we live under the monarchy of Spain. For 377 years, we live under the oppression of Spain, my dear brothers and sisters. We are being oppressed, meaning, my dear brothers and sisters, we are under fear. We have no freedom. We were a slave. We cannot make decisions for ourselves, my dear brothers and sisters. Amen? This later on leads to the Philippine revolutions. Paki-check kasi may slide tayo to just to appreciate, my dear brothers and sisters, no? So that's the lifestyle of our forefathers before under the colonial rules. Ibang-iba sa magaganda at magagarang kasuotan natin ngayon. That is the life of our ancestor under the colonial rule of Spain, under oppression, under fear, under freedom. Yun yung ipinapakita nila na mga kimono, yung mga magaganda. Hindi po yun yung tunay na picture, my dear brothers and sisters. Amen. And this later on leads to the Philippine Revolution, which is called Himagsikan. No? This is where a group of Filipino fighters are fighting the Spanish army. But later on, my dear brothers and sisters, later on at the end of the rule, a new power is emerging. And this power is called the United States of America. And we know that there's a lot of fighting that happened between the United States of America and Spain. Because what happens is during that time, Spain colonized nearly half of the world. And here comes another bully. Here comes another superpower. What does this another superpower would want to do? He would want to take over. He would want to colonize this country. So what happened? They wage war against Spain. And they have a lot of battles. They have a lot of fighting. And it proves, my dear brothers and sisters, that this new superpower, that this new emerged superpower, United States of America, is far more superior in strength than Spain. As an evidence, they are winning their battles. Nananalo po sila sa kanilang mga digmaan. Nananalo, pinapanalunan nila ang kanilang digmaan. And when they attack the Philippines in a battle of Manila Bay, the Philippines won against Spain. Amen? The Philippines won against Spain. And the Spain being defeated, ano po yung ginawa ng Spain? Spain said, "We surrender. Allow us to return to our country, our kingdom peacefully. Allow us to go out safely and alive, basically. As a return, we will give to you the rule of this nation. Ibibigay namin sa iyo ang pangangalaga sa Pilipinas na to. And that treaty is called the Treaty of Paris, by the Treaty of Paris, because it was ratified in Paris in 1898. But my dear brothers and sisters, this is what I want us to see. The leader of the Philippine Revolution, Himagsikan, then Andres Bonifacio and Emilio Aguinaldo. Emilio Aguinaldo is considered as the first Philippine president. The most important thing that they have done is when this treaty was signed, when they said that, okay, the Spanish are going out of the Philippines, the Americans are taking over, the Filipino Revolution, they made a decision. What did they do, my dear brothers and sisters? They said, enough is enough. We have been a slave under Spanish. We cannot continue to be enslaved by the Americans. We make our decision. It is the reason why that in June 12, 1898, in Kawit, Cavite, the Philippine Revolution declared themselves independence. For the very first time, this flag, that flag, was unfurled, history says, around 4:30 p.m. in the afternoon. Because if you imagine, before that, yung flag ng Pilipinas nakatago, yung flag ng Pilipinas nakatupi. But that is the very first time when the Philippine flags ay wave, iwinagayway. And alam natin that pagwawagayway ng flag, my dear brothers and sisters, means freedom. Amen. Means freedom. And this is what I want us to learn, my dear brothers and sisters. Ito po yung gusto kong matutunan natin ngayong araw na to. This is what I want us to receive as a message. The Spaniards did not give the Filipinos their independence. The Americans did not give the Filipinos their independence. Well, not at least unless up until 1946, when we were actually given freedom by the Americans. But on that day, my dear brothers and sisters, it was not the Spanish, it was not the Americans, it was us, the Filipinos, who declared, we are independent. Amen, church? We are independent. Amen? And for today's message, gusto kong ilagay natin sa ating puso, isa puso natin, yung mga nangyari sa panahong yan, my dear brothers and sisters. Because that can be very applied to our life today. Amen? I want us to consider, mga kapatid, that the Filipinos were under oppression. We were under fear. We cannot make our decisions for ourselves. We have no freedom. We were a slave. First, sabi nga natin, under the monarchy of Spain, and second, under the superpower America. Amen? And let's ponder this. The Spanish did not give us independence. The Americans did not give us independence. It was our forefathers who made that decisions. Amen. It was the Filipino people who declared independence. It was the Filipino people who waved that flag and say, freedom. Amen. It was the Filipinos who decided, I want to be free. It was the Filipinos who decided, I no longer want to be a slave. Amen, church. It was the Filipinos who made their decisions. The word of the Lord in Romans 3:23, pansin nyo, palaging lumalabas ito. Dahil this is our default stage. This is our default state. Romans 3:23, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Amen. So hindi na po natin kailangang tignan si brother, si sister. Hindi na natin tignan si ate, si kuya. Salamin na lang ang kailangan nating tignan. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Amen. What is the glory of God, my dear brothers and sisters? You know, in the Old Testament, if we read the Old Testament, it says in there, in the glory of God, descend in the midst of them. In the glory of God comes on top of that Ark of the Covenant. The glory of God, my dear brothers and sisters, means the very presence of God. The glory of God represents God Himself. Amen, church. So it says in here that we are all sinners. And because we are all sinners, we cannot come in the presence of God. We cannot stand in the presence of God. We cannot come into the glory of God. Amen, church. And John, 1 John 1:8, it says in there, if we say we have no sin, meaning, if we refuse to admit that we are a sinner, if we think that we are better than what we ought, if we think that there is no sin in us, if we think that we are a good person, the Bible says, if we say we have no sin, then that means we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. Imagine the principle of multiplication. If you claim that you are not a sinner, you immediately sin too. The sin of deception because you deceive yourself and the sin of lying because the truth is not in us. And the word of the Lord says, the native tongue of Satan is lie. Amen, church. But John 8:34, it says in here, Jesus replied, very truly I tell you, everyone who sins are slave to sins. Amen. So nakikita natin yung default stage natin. Can we imagine our default state, my dear brothers and sisters? Because we are all sinners, we cannot come, we cannot approach the very presence of God. Amen? And because we are all sinner, we are all slaves. Amen, church? We are all slave, we are all slave to sin, and we are all slave to the slave master, who is no other than Satan. Amen. So for all have sinned and are therefore cannot come into the presence of God, and because you are a sinner, you and me are a sinner, we are a slave to sin and to that slave master, the author of sin, who is no other than Satan. Amen, church? But it has not have to end that way. John 14:6. Jesus says, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. Amen. No one comes to the Father except through me. Amen. Jesus is simply saying us that though you are a sinner, and because you are a sinner, you cannot come into the presence of God. You fall short of the glory of God. Jesus is saying, though you are a sinner, though sin does not allow you to come and stand, present yourself in the very presence of the Father, but Jesus is telling you and me, I am more powerful than your sin. Your sin cannot allow you to come to the Father. Your sin cannot allow you to present yourself to the glory of the Father. But Jesus said, I am more powerful than your sin. I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. And through me, you can come to the Father. Through me, you can come to the glory of the Father. Amen, church? Jesus is more powerful. Amen. Jesus is more powerful than your slave master. Amen, church? Did it not it say in, I think, 1 John 4:4, that says in there, He who is in you, Jesus who is in you, is far greater, is far superior, is far more powerful than he, than Satan, than your slave master, than the author of sin who is in this world. Amen, church. My dear brothers and sisters, there is more powerful than he who is in this world. And he is not just a mere force. He is not just a mere power. He is not just a mere manifestation. His name is Jesus. Amen. His name is Jesus. And Jesus, my dear brothers and sisters, it says in there, can sympathize with us. Because our flesh represents Him. Our DNA represents Him. Our humanity represents Him. My dear brothers and sisters. Amen, church. Although God or Jesus was fully God, but He was fully man at the same time when He walked this earth. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, that you are more powerful than my sin. That you are more powerful than my slave master. Amen, church. Thank you, Jesus, that you are the way, the truth, and the life. And thank you that through you grant me access to the glory and to the presence of the Father. Amen, church. John 8:32, it says in there, you will know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Amen. You will know me, Jesus said. Jesus said, my name is truth. My name is life, my dear brothers and sisters. I am the way. Amen. Hallelujah. If you know the truth, if you know me, Jesus said, I can set you free. I can give you freedom from the bondage of your sin and from the slave master who is Satan. Amen, church. Hallelujah. Romans 10:13. Everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. Amen. Everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. And that is the reality. You can tell yourself, you can convince yourself that if I call upon the name of the Lord, that I will be saved. I will be saved from my burden. I will be saved from my pain. I will be saved from my sickness. I will be saved from my oppression. Amen. Everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. And His name is Jesus. Hallelujah. His name is Jesus. Anyone going through something right now? Anyone na may pinagdadaanan ngayon? Anyone na may bigatin ngayon? Anyone na may sitwasyon ngayon? Anyone, my dear brothers and sisters, na nakagawa ka ng kasalanan and you are waiting for that right time because of your conscience to surrender that sin to the Lord? Anyone who you think you failed, that you fell short of the glory of God, that you failed God recently? Anyone? You know what? I'm not gonna tell you a secret. I'm one of you. Amen. But today, declaration of faith. Everyone who is like me, everyone who failed the Lord, everyone who called upon the name of the Lord will be saved. And His name is Jesus. Can we shout, Jesus? Jesus! Jesus! Hallelujah! Everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. And His name is Jesus. His name is Emmanuel. That means that Jesus, God, you are with us. Amen, church. You know, when you call upon the name of the Lord, that makes you po Christian. Because calling upon the name of the Lord is believing in the name of the Lord. You cannot call on a name that you do not believe. Amen, church? So once you implore the name of the Lord, you begin believing in the Lord. And when you begin to believe in the Lord, what that makes you, my dear brothers and sisters? It makes you a believer. It makes you a Christian. Amen? And it says in there, everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. Pero yung tanong is, tanong ko din yan actually. Pero bakit po kaya nagkakasala pa rin tayo? Why do we still continue to sin? Why do we still cannot avoid sinning? Bakit patuloy pa rin tayong nagkakasala? Bakit hindi pa rin nating maiwasang magkasala? Kristiyano ka naman, di ba? Kristiyano naman ako, di ba? Bakit hindi pa rin po tayo, hindi natin mapigilang magkasala? Sino po mga kapatid dito honestly can put their hands in their heart that they have mastered sin? Na pastor kayo, hindi na ako nagkakasala. Sino po? And magpalit po tayo ng pwesto. Kayo po ang tumayo rito. Because the word of the Lord says, if you even claim that principle of multiplicity, you sin too. Because that is the sin of deception and lie. My dear brothers and sisters, ito yung gusto kong matutunan natin. I want us to learn this, na bakit kaya Kristiyano na ako? And I remember when we, especially after yung after Friday fellowship natin, na ito yung tanong na, di ba, Kristiyana na po tayo. Di ba, dapat hindi na tayo nagkakasala. And minsan pag nag-uusap tayo dun, parang makatotohanan. Pero hindi natin na i-apply kasi nagkakasala pa rin tayo. Amen. And yun yung tanong, bakit kaya tayo nagkakasala pa rin? And you know what, my dear brothers and sisters, even who I call the greatest apostle, Apostle Paul, struggled with the same predicament. Yung predicament na pinagdadaanan natin ngayon, pinagdaanan din ni Apostle Paul. If you open your Bible in Romans 7:15, I do not understand what I do, Apostle Paul says. For what I want to do, I do not do. But what I hate to do, I do. Amen. Sabi ni Apostle Paul, hindi ko maintindihan. Kasi yung mga bagay na ayaw kong gawin, ginagawa ko. Yung mga bagay na dapat kong gawin, hindi ko ginagawa. I do not understand what I want to do, Apostle Paul says. I want to walk in the righteousness of God, but I keep on failing. I want to walk in the holiness of God, but I keep on failing. Ilan po sa atin dito yun? Oh, una na ako. Sinong pangalawa? I do not know what I want to do, Apostle Paul says. I do not want to commit sin. I do not want to commit sinful acts. But I keep on failing. O sino pa pong pangalawa? Una na po ako. Amen, my dear brothers and sisters. In alam natin, Galatians 5:19 to 21, it says in there, these are the things na alam natin hindi natin dapat ginagawa, pero patuloy natin ginagawa. These are the things that we do not want to do, but we keep on doing them. The acts of our flesh. The sinful nature of ourself. Yung default nature natin. Kung sino tayo bago natin nakilala ang Panginoon. Kung ano tayo bago natin kilala ang Panginoon, isinasapamuhay pa rin natin hanggang ngayon. And my dear brothers and sisters, I'm not blaming you. I'm not putting fingers at you. Because let alone, Apostle Paul will himself point fingers to us all. At sabi niya rito, the acts of the flesh are obvious. These are just example, ah, makikita natin mamaya. Sexual immorality, impurity, debauchery, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, discord, jealousy, fits of rage, selfish ambition, dissension, factions, envy, drunkenness, orgies, and many likes. I warn you, as I did before, that those who live like this will not inherit the kingdom of God. You know, my dear brothers and sisters, as I was meditating this, the Holy Spirit just put a heavy impression, especially that we are celebrating Philippine Independence Day. My dear brothers and sisters, our nation, the Philippines, are in need of intercessors. Our nation, the Philippines, ay nangangailangan ng mga buhay para umiyak sa Panginoon, para magdasal sa Panginoon. Because I don't know if you realize, there is a brand new spiritual satanic power that is above the Philippines right now. That is a brand new, there is a brand new spiritual satanic power that is going in the Philippines right now. The level of idolatry in the Philippines right now, unimaginable. The level of hatred in the Philippines right now, unimaginable. The level of discord in the Philippines right now, unimaginable. The level of fits of rage in the Philippines right now, unimaginable. The level of factions in the Philippines right now, unimaginable. You know why? Because of politics. Because of politics, there is no love. Because of politics, people can only love those people who are in the same color as them. Who came from the Philippines during the election? Nandun kayo sa Philippines during election natin, Tess, ano? And who else? If you were in the Philippines during election, makikita mo, you can see the divide. You can see the divide of those people wearing the same color. But the sad thing is, tapos na ang election, pero hanggang ngayon. Amen, mga kapatid. Idolatry. Wala na yung pagmamahal sa kapwa. Wala na yung pagpapasensya sa kapwa. Tingnan mo ang Facebook, nagmumurahan sila dun. Tingnan mo sa Facebook, they kill each other in their mind and in their thought. That is murder, the Lord says. Murder is not the act of physical killing, but when you murder somebody in your mind, in your thought, in your heart, that is murder. So we need to cry for our nation, the Philippines. We need to cry for the Filipinos, my dear brothers and sisters. Dahil tunay nga, that we are in the end times. Amen. Let us pray for the Philippines. Let us pray for the deliverance and freedom from this new batch, new wave of satanic oppression. Amen. So what is our answer for us, Christian? Ano po yung sagot natin sa katulad ko, katulad nyo, na patuloy na gumagawa ng mga bagay na hindi natin dapat ginagawa? Na hindi gumagawa ng mga bagay, ng mga dapat na mga bagay na dapat nating ginagawa. Ano po yung kailangan nating gawin, my dear brothers and sisters? What do we need to do? Galatians chapter 5 verse 16 to 17, pay attention. The seed, the core of this message is nakapaloob in this passage. And I pray that this seed will be planted in your heart. That this seed will grow in your heart. That this seed will enable you sa area that we are failing. I do not know what I want to do. Those things that I do not want to do, I am doing them. Those things that I'm supposed to be doing, I do not do them. This is the answer, my dear brothers and sisters. Galatians, my dear brothers and sisters, 5:16 to 17. I say to you, walk by the Spirit, and you will not gratify the desire of the flesh. For the desire of the flesh are against the Spirit, and the desire of the Spirit are against the flesh. Pay attention. It reveals. For these are opposed to each other to keep you from doing the things you want to do. Amen. Ito yung sikreto. This is the secret, my dear brothers and sisters, that why we do the things that we do not want to do, and we do not do the things that we should not be doing, because it says in here, the spirit in the sinful nature are opposing each other. Amen? And guess what? Not because you received the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, that your sinful nature is gone. Nandyan pa rin. Nandyan pa rin. So as long as we live in this flesh, so as long as our body has not yet been glorified, mga kapatid, nandyan yung tendency. Amen. Ayan na yung what is the secret. It says in here, walk by the Spirit. It says in here, my dear brothers and sisters, he did not say, no? Notice this, he did not say, have the Holy Spirit. Hindi niya sinabing, have the Holy Spirit and you will not gratify. He did not say, have the Holy Spirit. He did not say, having the Holy Spirit meaning salvation. Amen. Salvation meaning believing in the Lord Jesus Christ. Believing in the Lord Jesus Christ meaning being a Christian. So hindi niya po sinasabi na you become a Christian. Hindi niya po sinasabi na have the Holy Spirit. Dahil mga kapatid, you already have the Holy Spirit. The moment na naging Kristiyano ka, you already have the Holy Spirit of the Lord in you. Amen? Pero bakit tayo nagkakasala? Why do we keep on failing? Because it is more than having the Holy Spirit. It says in there, walk by the Spirit. Amen. Having the Spirit and walking by the Spirit is two different entry. Amen po. Kaya nga sabi natin, I have the Holy Spirit. Papaano ko ba natanggap yung Holy Spirit? Isn't it we receive the Holy Spirit when we believe in the Lord? Amen? When we became Christian, that's the time that we receive the Holy Spirit. Amen? Do you agree with me? Do you agree as well when I say that you already believe in the Lord? Do you agree as well when I say that because you believe in the Lord, you have the Holy Spirit? Then the question is, why do you still sin? Because we do not walk by the Spirit. So Apostle Paul is saying, more than just receiving the Holy Spirit, walk by the Holy Spirit. Kaya ngayong sabi ni Sister Cherry kanina, kailangan mayroon tayong gawin. Amen. We have the Holy Spirit. That is the act of God. Yun yung ginawa ng Panginoon, yung ibinigay yung Holy Spirit sa atin. Amen, mga kapatid. E tayo, ano po yung kailangan nating gawin? We need to walk by the Holy Spirit. Amen? The Lord has already gave you your armor. Amen? Tignan nga natin kung sino ang responsible dito. Sino po yung armor of God nila? Sino po dito yung ang kanilang armor, my dear brothers and sisters, ay shining, na talagang pinupunasan, perfect. Sino po yung armor nila, mga kapatid, dito ay talagang shining, talagang walang bahid? Sino po, mga kapatid? Anyone? Kasi the last time I checked, my armor is overworn. My armor is overused. My armor is full of dent. My dear brothers and sisters, that's why it says in there, you wear your armor. Do not keep your armor in your cabinet and maintain it pristine and clean. That's the only reason na yung armor mo is pristine and clean, because you keep it in the covenant. But the Lord says, put on the full armor of God. Kailangan meron po tayong gawin. Amen, my dear brothers and sisters. Amen. Walk by the Holy Spirit, meaning we already have the Holy Spirit. We are already saved by the virtue of believing in our Lord Jesus Christ. But it says in here, now we need to walk in the Spirit. We need to walk in faith. Amen, church? We need to walk in the Holy Spirit. Amen? Kailangan tayong may gawin. Ano yung kanta kanina? Maghari ka, maghari ka. What is yung paki-extend nung ano na yun? Panginoong Hesus, maghari ka sa buhay ko. No? Maghari ka, Panginoon. It's more than a song. It's more than a declaration. Many people will say, Panginoon, maghari ka. Pero hindi nila pinagbubuksan ng pintuan ang Panginoon. Many people will say, maghari ka, Panginoon. Maghari ka, Panginoon. Pero ayaw nilang ibaba yung pinanghahawakan nilang saradura. Ayaw nilang pagbuksan yung kandado. That's the reason why, my dear brothers and sisters, today is the day of reckoning. Yes, like you and me, people online, and many of us in here, we are Christian, we are saved. But today, we need a different kind of decision to make. That is to walk by the Holy Spirit. Amen. I am not asking people right now, if you are not yet saved, obviously that is the basic foundation to have the Holy Spirit for you to receive the Lord Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. But if you have already received the Lord Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, meaning you already have the Holy Spirit, the decision that we are asked today, my dear brothers and sisters, is to make that decision to walk by the Spirit. Amen. Ito lang po yung paraan, sabi niya rito sa passage na to. This is the only remedy to address yung problema ng mga Kristiyano na yung mga bagay na hindi nila dapat gawin, ginagawa nila. Na yung mga bagay na dapat nilang gawin, hindi nila ginagawa. Amen, my dear brothers and sisters. I was blessed yung kanta ni Kuya Will kanina. Ano yung kanta niyan? Ang buong buhay ko, amen. Ang tanging alay ko, sa'yo aking ama. Ang buong buhay ko, puso't kaluluwa. Pero sometimes we kubet. Father God, ang tanging alay ko ay ito lang. Pwede bang wag mong kunin yung buong buhay ko? Pwede bang panghawakan ko muna ito ng 3 linggo? Pwede bang panghawakan ko muna ito ng 2 linggo? Tao lang kasi, hindi ako makamove on quickly. Tao lang kasi, wala akong kakayahan. My dear brothers and sisters, sabi ko nga kahapon when we were in I do not mean to preach na makasakit, but we need to be truthful and honest. We need to be truthful and honest. The word of the Lord is sharper than double-edged sword. Meaning, pag hindi po tayo nahihiwa sa bawat salita ng Panginoon, hindi yan salita ng Panginoon. Kung hindi po tayo nasusugatan sa bawat salita ng Panginoon, hindi po yan salita ng Panginoon. Mabuti nga yung sabi ng Panginoon eh. Hayaan mong ako ang sumugat sa iyo dahil kaya kitang pagalingin. Amen, church. So my dear brothers and sisters, katulad po ng ating mga Filipino ancestors 124 years ago, when they made that decision to declare independence from the oppression of Spain. Sabi nga natin, Spain did not give it to them. The Americans did not give it to them. but they made the decision to declare it. They made the decision to walk on it. Amen. Hindi pa man ibinibigay ng Espanya, ng Amerika ang kanilang kalayaan, pero inilakad nila ang kanilang kalayaan. Amen, church. And we are encouraged to make that decision now to walk in that freedom, to walk by the Spirit of God. Amen. Mga kapatid, sabi ko nga again, kung hindi mo pakilala ang Panginoong Hesukristo, if you have not yet received the Lord Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, this is the time to receive Him. Because the Holy Spirit can only come to you after receiving the Lord Jesus Christ. But majority of us, or maybe all of us, have already received the Lord Jesus Christ. Meaning we already have the Holy Spirit. The decision that we need to make now is to walk by that Spirit, to walk by that Spirit. Amen. We are faced with decision right now, my dear brothers and sisters. Sabi ko nga, I'm not asking you to tell your neighbor. What I'm asking you is to make that decision. Tell yourself that, Lord, I am ready. I am willing to walk by that Spirit. Amen, church. Jesus have already made the provision of freedom in Calvary's cross. Amen, church. Ibinigay niya na po yung kalayaan natin in the cross of Calvary. Hindi natin kailangang kunin ang kalayaan ngayon. Ang kailangan lang natin ngayon, ilakad ang ating kalayaan. Walk your freedom, my dear brothers and sisters. Are you going to make that decision today, to walk your freedom? Are you going to walk by the Spirit? Are you going to be led by the Spirit on that path that leads to righteousness and life? Amen? 2 Corinthians 3:17, it says in there, the Lord is a Spirit. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Amen. Mga kapatid, make that decision. Let us no longer let the work of the enemy deceive us, oppress us, enslave us, because we have the Spirit of God. Amen. And God is a Spirit. And everyone who has the Spirit of God walks in freedom. The word of the Lord says, to anyone who is freed by the Lord, are free indeed. Amen. Let's all stand up and let's invite the music team. And let us ponder. Let us desire, mga kapatid. Let us cry to the Holy Spirit to enable us to arrive in that decision to walk in that freedom. Na isapamuhay yung freedom na yan. John 8:36, if the Son sets you free, you are free indeed. Mga kapatid, hindi po natin kailangang punitin ang ating sedula. Di po natin kailangang punitin ang ating mga pasaporte katulad ng ginawa nila dati. But what we can give up right now is that flesh. What we can give up right now is that sinful nature. Upang sa ganun ay makalakad tayo sa Espiritu. Amen po. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. In Romans, Obligation means, mga kapatid, pag sinabing mayroon kang obligasyon, what does that mean? Kailangan mong gawin, di po ba? Do you agree with me? If you have an obligation, kailangan mong gawin. And the word of the Lord says, people of God, we have an obligation. And that obligation is not to the sinful nature to live according to it. For if you live according to the sinful nature, you will die. But we have an obligation to the Holy Spirit to live and walk according to the Holy Spirit. Sige po mga kapatid. Let us let the Lord, the Holy Spirit, minister to us through the life of our music team.
Kapag iyong kalooban nanunumbalik sa iyong paglingap,
payagan natin ang Panginoon,
dinadalangin ang iyong pagtanggap,
payagan natin ang Panginoon na bumilos,
hinahanap ang iyong katuwiran.
Pagbuksan natin ang Panginoon, mga kapatid,
iyayak kapag iyong
allow the Holy Spirit of God to open our
hearts.
Allow the Holy Spirit of God to open our heart.
Dinadalangin.
Allow the Holy Spirit of God to enter our puso.
Hinahanap ang iyong katuwiran.
Lower your guard.
Niyayakap ang iyong
lower your guard, church.
Nanunumbalik sa iyong paglingap, dinadalangin ang iyong pagtanggap, hinahanap ang iyong katwiran.
Kumilos ka sa Panginoon sa buhay ko,
iyayak ka pang iyong
kumilos ka sa buhay ng iyong
iglesia. Nanunumbalik dinadalangin ang iyong
umilos ka sa aking pagsamba,
hinahanap ang iyong katwiran.
People of God,
kapang iyong kalooban.
Lower your guard.
Maghari ka, maghari ka.
Just bow yourself.
Panginoon Jesus, maghari ka.
Pagbuksan natin ang
habilon.
Katong ang Panginoon sa iyong puso.
Nanunumbalik sa iyong palihan.
Pagbuksan natin
ang Panginoon. Dinadalangin ang iyong pagtanggap. Hinahanap ang iyong katwiran. Niyayakap ang iyong kalooban. Nanunumbalik sa iyong paglihat. Dinadalangin ang iyong pagtanggap. Hinahanap ang iyong katwiran. Niyayakap ang iyong kalooban. Sa buhay ko, sa puso ko, Panginoong Jesus, maghari ka. Maghari ka, maghari ka, Panginoong Jesus, maghari ka. Jesus, maghari ka. Sa buhay ko, sa puso ko, Panginoong Jesus, maghari ka.
Let us welcome the Lord, mga kapatid. Pagbuksan natin ang Panginoon. Kumakatok siya sa bawat puso sa lugar na to. If you are joining us online, kumakatok ang Panginoon sa bawat puso right now. And this is about making that decision na more than just desiring for the Lord to reign above our life. Why don't we allow Him? Tapos na po yung kasabihan natin na tulak ng bibig, kabig ng dibdib. Mga kapatid, pag gusto nating maghari ang Panginoon sa ating buhay, then kailangan nating may gawin. Kailangan tayong may gawin. Buksan natin ang ating puso. Ibaba natin ang ating mga trangka. Buksan natin ang mga kandado na yan. Kapatid, brother, sister, kuya, ate, tita, mga anak, the Lord has delivered you. And the word of the Lord says, the spirit you receive does not make you slaves again, so that you will continue to live in fear. Rather, the spirit you receive brought about your adoption to sonship. By that spirit, we can cry, Abba, Father, Ama. Pansinin niyo yung mga bata, pag umiiyak, pag inaaway, pag may kailangan, ano yung sabi? Daddy. And it could be that you are in that stage right now na ang mundo hindi ka pinapaboran. It could be that you are in the stage right now na dumadanas ka sa isang matinding pagsubok. It could be na dumadanas ka sa isang matinding karamdaman. It could be that a family member is unwell. It could be that a family member is hooked to drugs. It could be that a family member ay wala nang pinapakinggan. It could be na si tatay, si nanay, si kuya, si ate, ang kapatid sa Pilipinas, they are under vices. And it could be that you have that burden to pray for the Philippines, for that new wave of spiritual and satanic forces. Mga kapatid, you have that power. Make that decision and walk by the Spirit. It is for freedom that Christ has set you free. Stand firm, therefore, and do not let yourself be burdened again. Do not get tied up again. Do not be entangled again by that yoke of slavery. My dear brothers and sisters, declaration of faith. Wala tayong sedula, wala tayong passport. Hindi natin kailangan magpunit, but we can trample on that sin. We can trample on that slavery. We can trample on Satan, the slave master. Come on, people of God. Trample on the works of the enemy. Walk by the Spirit. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. I receive freedom from this illness. I receive freedom from this acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. I receive freedom from this tumor. I receive freedom from this bladder problem. I receive freedom from these back problems. I receive freedom from this blood pressure, hypertension, heart problems. I receive freedom from this seizure. I receive freedom from this anxiety, depression. I receive freedom from this spiritual oppression. I receive freedom from this lack, from this financial difficulty, from this financial instability. I receive freedom, Lord. I receive freedom, Father God. Lord, I receive freedom by continuing to do the things that I should not be doing and by not doing the things that I ought to be doing, I receive freedom, Father God. And I am walking on that freedom. I am walking on that freedom. I am walking on that spirit. My dear brothers and sisters, hallelujah. Mga kapatid, isa lang po, there is only one thing left to do. There's only one thing left to be done. Our Lord Jesus Christ completed everything in the cross. Ginawa na po niyang lahat sa cross. Ibinigay na po niyang lahat sa cross, my dear brothers and sisters. Wala nang kulang, wala nang karagdagan. Wala na tayong hinihintay na kulang, wala na tayong karagdagan, wala na tayong hinihintay na pangkompleto. Ang kailangan na lang nating gawin, make that decision to walk in that freedom, to walk by the Spirit of God. Amen. Hallelujah, Lord. I wanna pray for each and every one of us. I wanna pray for us, and I wanna pray for the church. And can I invite each and everyone to close our eyes and let us be in the presence of the Lord. Yes, let us close our eyes with the exemption of no one, including me. Including me. Let us close our eyes and hallelujah, all eyes are closed. And my dear brothers and sisters, all eyes are closed. And throughout the prayer, if you believe na ikaw yung nangangailangan, if you believe that you are in need, and if you believe that that is for you, as a sign of declaration, as a sign of acknowledgement to the Lord, why don't you just raise your hand? And you don't even have to keep it there. Just raise your hand and be counted. Just raise your hand. My dear brothers and sisters, this is an act of faith. Because in order for the Lord to work, there needs to be an act of faith. So all eyes are closed now. I don't even see you. Hallelujah, Lord. Father, thank you for the provision of freedom that you have given for humanity to behold. And that freedom is called Jesus. That in the name of your Son Jesus, in the fullness of His sacrifice, suffering and death on that cross, Father, our freedom has been provided for. And thank you very much, Father, that the life of your Son Jesus is complete. And Father, I acknowledge my nature that I am in need. Amen. I acknowledge, Lord, that I am a sinner. And being a sinner, Father God,
I am prohibited to come in your glory. And as a sinner, Father God, that I cannot come to you. That as a sinner, Father, the wages of that sin is eternal separation, suffering in death throughout eternity. Thank you. Thank you, Lord, that although I am in need, thank you, Lord, that although I am a sinner, thank you, Lord, that although I am incapable of loving you, but you have loved me first. Thank you, Lord, that you have loved me first. That though I am a sinner, that though I am incapable, that your Son Jesus died instead of me. That your Son Jesus died in place of me on that cross. And thank you so much, Father, that His death on that cross, by the power of the Holy Spirit who resurrected Him from the dead, is the same Spirit that is on offer here today. Lord, I want to receive your Holy Spirit. I want to receive your Holy Spirit. And I understand that in order for me to receive your Holy Spirit, that I need to believe in your Son Jesus and His perfect work in the cross. That I need to believe in Romans 10:9. And not only me, but also my families will be saved. Lord, I want to receive that Holy Spirit right now. Father, it could be that I have received the Holy Spirit before. I am not sure. But right here, right now, I am making that decision to receive your Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, come in my life. Holy Spirit, enter in my life. By virtue of my belief, of my surrender, of my submission to the name of your Son Jesus. Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit that gives freedom. As I receive you, Holy Spirit, I want to walk in you. I want to walk with you. I want to walk through you. I want to walk through that freedom right now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for that freedom. Freedom from my pain. Freedom from oppression. Freedom from deception. Freedom from betrayal. Freedom from being not loved. Freedom from not being considered. Freedom from my illness. Freedom from my sickness. Freedom from my diseases. Freedom from my relationship. Freedom from my financial instability. Lord, thank you for the offered freedom. I want to behold it right now. Gusto kong panghawakan yung freedom na yan, Panginoon. I am making that decision right now to hold on to that freedom and to walk on that freedom and to live in that freedom. And isa pamuhay ang freedom na yan. Thank you, Lord, that I have an obligation not to yield to the sinful nature but to glorify the Spirit that is in me. Lord, walang nalilingit sa'yo. Andirito po kami, Panginoon. May pangangailangan. Imperfect. Imperfect. Far from the creation that you desire. Lord, allow us to come in your glory. Amen.
Allow us, Father, to be able to come in your presence through the way, the truth, and the life. Through Jesus. Father, hindi nalilingid sa iyo ang sitwasyon ng mga kapatid kong ito, ang sitwasyon ng mga anak mo, ng mga tao mo. Kung may pinagdadaanan ka, kapatid, all eyes are closed. Declaration of faith as a sign of surrender. Why don't you just raise your hand to the Lord and say that, Lord, alam mo na may pangangailangan ako. Alam mo na may pinagdadaanan ako. Alam mo, Panginoon, na may isang bagay that I have been trying to overcome, pero wala akong kakayahan. Ngayon, sa iyo ako dumudulog dahil alam kong ikaw lamang ang may kakayahan. Panginoon, nakikita mo ang mga kamay na to, nakikita mo ang mga pusong bukas na to, nakikita mo ang mga pintuang bukas na to. Lord, Holy Spirit, enter your people, enter their life, and enter their circumstances. Declare your independence from the corruption of this world, mga kapatid. We are free! I am free! I am free! Sa lahat ng mga tao na nakatanggap ng kalayaan ngayong araw na to, say Jesus! Jesus! Hallelujah! Jesus! 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 His name is Jesus! His name is Jesus! His name is Jesus. Mga kapatid, hindi po ito orasyon. If you go to the world and you feel threatened, if you go to the world and you feel challenged by situation, circumstance, spirit, body, and soul, invoke the name of Jesus. It is not a secret. The enemy, Satan, knows that you know, that he knows that he is powerless against Jesus. Amen. 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 May God bless you all. Thank you very much.
Once again, muli po, pwede po tayong mag-declare ng victory today. Minsan pa nga po lahat tayo tumayo. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Habang inaawit po natin ito, ang tanong po, nag-decide na ba kayo na palayain ang sarili?
Amen!
Amen! Praise the Lord! Huwag mong hayaan na ikaw